So we're here with Victor. Right, tell us your last name.
Gonzalez.
And it's okay to interview you, right?
Yeah, sure.
Well, so I wanted, in talking to you earlier, I wanted to touch on the fact that, tell us where you're going to school at right now.
I'm going to USC in Los Angeles.
What are you studying?
I'm studying music industry and film.
Okay. And where'd you go to high school at?
I went to Desmarais High School.
Well, and so this is your first year, so tell us how you ended your first year there at
USC. I ended my first year on pretty good grounds. I really enjoyed the experience of going to a four-year university outside of the Coachella Valley in Los Angeles. Really enjoyed the city, learning the college experience. Of course, you're going to have a couple downfalls, but in the end of the day, I really enjoyed the classes I was taking and really looking forward to the next 3 years.
Tell us a little bit about your drive home from USC, coming back to the desert.
It didn't hit me, the feeling of not going back to my dormitory, of knowing that, oh wait, I'm coming back home. Okay, that's different. But then it didn't hit me that, you know, a week here that, oh, I would need a job. I would need to be able to do something, right? There was no real transition for me to go from going to school and then coming back to the valley, you know?
What do you think needs to happen in order to have more opportunities for youth in the summer when they're out of school?
Let's see. Y'all do great programs, and of course people ask for money, ask for grants here and there. At the same time, you know, again, creating jobs, like, that's a tough prospect. It's not just businesses. It's, again, like, we need to develop those programs and expand them to include more people. And everyone needs a helping hand. Everyone needs that expertise. There's a lot of folks with the skill. You know, they come back and they need that experience. And even some have that experience, have those skills. So as far as, like, creating jobs, we come back and we look around in our communities and there's just no jobs. No one's hiring, not even for part-time workers, not even for odd jobs here and there. Like, it's tough. Again, it's real tough. But it's needed. It's a necessity. And as far as, like, creating those jobs, there's plenty of those programs, you know. We just need that funding to allow for more folks coming in. You know, because using that money for, let's say, an event, well, yeah, that's cool, you have your event, but you need something long-lasting. You need something where people come in and contribute.
What sort of jobs would you like to see for you?
Well, looking around my community, and again, there are no jobs. Like, I would love to have worked with the youth and the Boys and Girls Club. Again, not hiring. I would love to work with, like, a summer program. Again, like, I enjoy working with youth. I enjoy working with community organizers. And these programs are present. At the same time, they're not hiring or they're not accepting help. So opening up those programs, expanding them, like, that's what we need to do. Because, again, we're lending a service to the community and we have folks that want to help. And we have a need for jobs.